Especially all Assassin's Creed fans. You were all waiting to see how the second part of our Steelbook Frenzy will look like. You were asking where to get this or that Steelbook and why this one was not available. So the second part will answer all your questions. Let's go! Now, where are we? Oh, I remember. Assassin's Creed 3 and Assassin's Creed Anthology. So, we need to move to Big Pirate time. After Assassin's Creed 3, which was not as such success as Ubisoft has hoped, we got Assassin's Creed 4, and we were moving backward in time in order to meet pirates. No, not really those from Caribbean, at least not from those Disney movie, but a little bit more realistic pirates. As a result, we got standard Steelbook edition for Assassin's Creed that was available in North America, and also Black Skull edition that was a collector edition that came with steel case that looked pretty similar to same to that North American Steelbook. Again, Europe, and they got, according to myself, the best of it, because their Steelbook is much more colorful and overall nicer. And yes, luckily we have only those three, as they are kind of available all over internet. So hopefully they won't become unicorns as what happened to those others from part one. Once this was done and they were back on track, they came with a big project. French Revolutions and Assassins. In other words, Assassin's Creed Unity. And boy, were the retailers hungry of this. So, we don't get any standard Steelbook edition, save for one, but we got several limited only to this or that retailer. Canada got their Future Shop Steelbook with the same style of design as Assassin's Creed 3. Then US got one that looked like a window from Notre Dame, maybe? I don't know, a little bit too surrealistic for my taste, but some people might like it. And Austria got their own steelbook with nice German writing on it. That one look a little bit more vivid and nicer. And finally, we got one official Ubisoft steelbook in their Guillotine edition, and this one is hardest to get. Plus, we got one steel box, and if you guessed Europe and Australia only again, you guessed correctly. So this one was from Bastille edition. Sadly enough, all those nice steel books could not save the game, and Ubisoft finally had to do something about it. So they released Syndicate. People were questioning, will this be another Unity or not? Retailers were careful this time. That's why we only have one Amazon Limited Steelbook, plus the one from the biggest Big Ben edition. Syndicate went rather well, and we were all hyped up. We are going to Egypt, pyramids, Sphinx, all those nice exotic things that you can get. Luckily or not luckily, we only have two steelbooks there. One from the Golden Edition with steelbook, and one from the Collector's Editions, either Dawn of the Creed or Dawn of the Creed Legendary Edition. That's what makes this second steelbook much rarer than the first one. And finally, finally, we are in old Greece. This is the last game. This is the one that changed all. And here we got 3 steelbooks in total. 3, not 2. The first one is from the standard gold edition with steelbook, widely available in North America. And this is also the one that all collectors in North America got in their Spartans and Patreon editions. But European and Australian collectors, on the other hand, got something else. A red looking one. Here I am on the fence which one is nicer from outside. I would kind of say that North American looks a little bit better. However, from the inside point of view, I would vote for European. And on the top of that, a limited Athenian edition, which practically contains just game, a small weapon pack, and a special steelbook, of course. And again, none of this was available in North America. Why would it be? So, this is all up to Odyssey. What? I forgot something? Let me finish. This is all up to Odyssey. But we still have one left. This one is the last steelbook that we have ever seen. It is for a remastered version of Assassin's Creed 3. Which means that, funny enough, we are ending with the same game that we have ended our last video. And this, my Assassins, is all the steelbooks there are, at least that I know about. And I did my research. But if ever you know about something that was released in some corner of Russia, China, India, maybe Korea, and was official, let me know please. I would happily add it for all of you to know. If you have enjoyed this video, give it a like, do not forget to subscribe, and next time I will start my comprehensive collector's guide of all collector's editions they were over the time. I am already researching them all, and be sure there are plenty. Thank you very much, and see you next time. Bye!